Hey everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today I will help you fix a really frustrating error that pops up sometimes when you're trying to update Windows 11 or 10. It's called error 0x80240438 and it usually says something like there were some problems installing updates. Don't worry, you're definitely not alone and luckily there are multiple ways to solve it. I'm going to guide you through each method step by step. First things first, let's understand why this error even happens. It could be a firewall issue, a network setting that's blocking the updates, or even a small glitch inside the update components themselves. The good news is we can fix all of these and you don't have to be a tech expert to do it. All right, step one, let's start by checking your internet connection. Yeah, I know it sounds basic, but sometimes your Wi-Fi or Ethernet might be unstable, causing the update to fail. Try resetting your router or switching to a different network just to be sure. If your internet seems fine, move on to the next step. Now let's disable any third-party antivirus software temporarily. Some antivirus programs can mistakenly block the Windows update servers. So try turning it off just for now. Don't worry, we will turn it back on once we finish updating. All right, now for step three, run the Windows Update Troubleshooter. Here's how you do it. Click on the Start button, then go to Settings. From there, click on System, then Troubleshoot, and then Other Troubleshooters. Now find Windows Update in the list and click Run next to it. Windows will scan your system and automatically fix some common problems. Give it a few minutes, follow any on-screen instructions, and then try running updates again. If you're still seeing the error after running the troubleshooter, let's dive a little deeper. We're going to restart the Windows Update services manually. Here's how. Press Windows R to open the Run dialog, type in services.msc, and hit Enter. Now scroll down and find these three services, Windows Update, Background Intelligent Transfer Service, and Cryptographic Services. Right-click on each, click Restart if it's running or Start if it's stopped. Basically, you're giving them a fresh start, and this can often clear out any issues that were blocking updates. Next, we're going to reset the Windows Update cache manually. I know it sounds scary, but it's actually pretty easy. First, open Command Prompt as administrator. You can do that by searching for CMD in the Start menu, right-clicking it, and choosing Run as Administrator. In the Command Prompt, type the following commands one by one, pressing Enter after each. First, type netspace stop space WUAUSERV. After that finishes, type in netspace stop space BITS. And then after that, run the command netspace stop space CRYPTSVC. Now open your file explorer and go to this path C, Windows Software Distribution. Inside that folder, select everything and delete it. Don't worry, these are just temporary update files and Windows will recreate them automatically. After you delete those files, go back to the command prompt and type these commands to restart the services. First one, type netspace start space WUAUSERV, and then go ahead and type netspace start space BITS. After that, simply type the command netspace start space CRYPTSVC. Now try checking for updates again. Fingers crossed this alone fixes the problem for a lot of people. Still having issues? All right, let's check your Windows firewall settings. Sometimes the firewall is too strict and blocks update connections without you even realizing it. Go to Control Panel, System and Security, then Windows Defender Firewall. On the left side, click Allow an app or feature through Windows Defender Firewall. Make sure Windows Update is allowed through both private and public networks. If you're using a custom DNS or VPN, it could also cause the error. Try disabling any VPN connections temporarily. Also, if you're using a custom DNS, switch back to automatic DNS settings or try using Google's DNS by setting it to 8.8.8.8.8 and 8.8.8.4.4. That sometimes speeds up the connection to Microsoft services too. One last method, if nothing else has worked, is to use the Windows Update Assistant. Just go to the official Microsoft website, download the Windows Update Assistant, and follow the prompts. It's basically an official tool that forces updates to install even if the normal update process is broken. And that's it. One of these methods should definitely fix the error for you. I know it can feel overwhelming, but just be patient and go step by step. You will get it sorted. If this video helped you out, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more tech tutorials just like this one. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.